Joining me today, this time not at the end of my table, unfortunately, but on the big screen is Morgan Richter with the Huntsville BIA. Morgan, thanks for taking the time today from joining us from your home. And wanted to talk a bit about what's happening with businesses in downtown right now. Obviously, with the lockdown, it's been pretty, it's been pretty tough. So I wanted to get a temperature check on these businesses, how things are going for them, and what the BIA is doing to support. So let's start, first of all, with what you're hearing from these businesses. How are they doing right now?
Yeah, so the businesses downtown are suffering. I mean, everyone is closed in terms of regular shopping, but most places are open for curbside pickup, and they're still trying their hardest to get the goods to our community. Typically this time of year is slower anyways for downtown Huntsville. So I think people are starting to just take a break and start thinking about our upcoming streetscape project. But they are still downtown and most are open to continue, serving our community.
So what role right now does the BIA play in helping the downtown businesses? Obviously you can't be walking up and down the street as you usually do, visiting in with them. How is your role changed right now?
Yeah, so right now I would say the BIA is just as busy, if not busier. So we are the conduit. So we are trying our hardest to help the businesses in terms of information gathering and giving them the information they need regarding COVID and COVID relief. We're also doing our best to keep our name on the map in terms of marketing and doing social media campaigns and different marketing ideas. So for instance, we just launched a Valentine's Day. So we're giving businesses chocolate to give away with curbside pickup. So if a restaurant does a dinner special, they can give away a box of chocolate on behalf of the BIA. So the BIA is thinking outside of the box on how we can still make sure people think of downtown Huntsville. And one day consumer confidence will come back, and we want to make sure that people still know who we are and are still willing to come downtown and support us when that time comes.
Where do you find the balance right now of supporting local businesses, but also staying away from the marketing of outside of the community because the province has asked everyone to stay within their own community? So where is that balance for you right now?
So the BIA does typically focus our efforts on local. We don't typically, spend too much effort thinking outside of our local community. So there is a fine line between the balance of the provincial COVID, recommendations and still making sure that our businesses stay afloat. So we work with the chamber and everybody to follow that fine line. But right now we're just focusing our attention on the local demographic.
Streetscape obviously is coming up. Where is the BIA right now in terms of planning for what's going to be happening with that?
So the BIA Streetscape starting in spring, which is about 70 days away or just under 70 days. So the BIA has hosted our annual brainstorming session as well as our AGM. And we're now full force into thinking about a construction season as well as the effects of COVID. So a lot of different initiatives are happening. We're thinking of our traditional events in a completely different way because we have to with Streetscape and COVID. But how can the BIA create incentives to bring folks downtown? So we're looking at teaming up with Explorer's Edge and doing some of those amazing voucher coupons, but exclusive for downtown Huntsville. Also teaming up with the Huntsville Festival of the Arts to do murals, and hopefully we can have some buskers downtown. We're talking about doing a community time capsule buried under the main street. So there's a lot of safe and fun initiatives that we're really excited to do this year. And again, just to keep Huntsville on the map, downtown Huntsville, but make construction a really fun project.
Fantastic. Well, we look forward to seeing what comes of that. Hopefully, at that point, we'll be able to start shopping in the stores again. We'll keep our fingers crossed for that. Morgan, thank you very much for taking the time today. Thank you for all the work you're doing, helping our local businesses stay afloat.